Hey everybody, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with another Mega Bloks Halo set. This is the Ultimate Combat Pack for 2013, set number 97233. It's basically just a giant minifigure pack. It comes with 20 minifigs, plus a bunch of accessories, plus a stand for all of them, for $50.
Sweet!
So you actually build this stand that all these guys go on, and it's a simple, quick build, but it's great. Because everybody likes to display their figures, right? This is really a collection here. Even if you don't have a collection yet, this is a collection in and of itself. And it's nice to be able to be proud of your collection and, you know, have a good way to show them off, even if it's only to yourself. You know, you want to look at them, you want to see, oh yeah, that's cool. And this is really nicely done. It's kind of, you know, they're steps. They're kind of like grandstands a little bit, and gives you plenty of room to spread these guys out. You can easily fit in many more figures than this. You've got the four emblems across the front, nicely reproduced, and lots of figures. I will go through them in groups, and I'll just tell you right now, I am not a full-time Mega Bloks Halo collector. I'm not a full-time Halo player by any means. I mean, you know, adult life and all that kind of stuff. So I'm not gonna know or remember all of the details of which part of which figure first came out in which year and which series and stuff. And I'm not ashamed of the fact that I don't know that stuff. And I'm not gonna try to cover up the fact that I don't know all that stuff by Googling it and taking notes and stuff. So I'm just gonna show you the figures as figures and have fun doing it. Grunts. Yep, I'm starting at the bottom of the totem pole and working my way up. So, two regular grunts here and two spec op grunts. One of each in cyan and the other in the slightly pearly orange color. Left to right, we've got a old style plasma pistol. The old style one with the kind of violet color, kind of metallic violet color. So they kind of digged into the vault to get that out. And then these two guys here are both in suicide mode, and they've got the dual plasma grenades, and they're purple. I like that. And then the last guy, the last Spec Ops guy, is holding a needler, and that's in that nice maroon, kind of dark reddish color, also metallic. And just looking around on the back of them, I mean, these are grunts. You know, you can't expect too much out of grunts, but nice to see cyan coming back into the mix, and, you know, it's just some troop building items here. So three brutes walked into a bar. One of them was just a regular brute. Two of them were jump pack brutes. And one of them had a transparent active camo, transparent cyan coloring. And I don't have any punchline to the joke because it's not intended to be a joke, just a pun. Fail. Anyway, regular guy here has the nice, again, the kind of maroon, reddish colored plasma rifle. I put that on upside down intentionally. I always do that so that you can get more range of motion out of them. Black spike grenade. Pretty nice painting on this guy with the little blue bits in there. The eyes are pretty obvious. This guy's got a mauler, and this one, interestingly enough, has a little bit of eye detail. They actually painted little black specks for eyes in there. Has the exact same molds as this guy here. So that's, you know, if you're trying to see the shape, you can see it much more easily here. He's also got a plasma rifle. I really like that color. I think that's just beautiful. The idea of actually showing the eyes, it's not painted perfectly, but it's not too bad, is something that could be considered controversial. You know, active camo should be completely clear, but I dig it. I think it adds to the personality of the figure. And I think it kind of adds more presence. I like it. I really like this jump pack in this color, in the cyan, and this one is actually not the exact same color as the paint that you see on these, on their bodies. This is slightly more minty, slightly more green, a little bit lighter. It just looks really great, that color with this mold, with the sharp lines and edges. I think that just might actually look better than the others with the more realistic colors. So there you go. There's your three brutes. I've seen them from all angles. What do we have next? Elites. Three of them balancing things out. Over here we got a pilot, and obviously all these guys are in the same color. We've got the pilot with the cyan eyes and the cyan marking on the head also, and he's got the needler in the same kind of dark maroon. It's the same color. It came out a little bit darker on this one, but I believe it's the same iridescent maroon. Then you've got a commando with a plasma repeater, a very beautiful looking weapon, very nicely done by Mega Bloks in this scale. I never used that weapon much in game. I wasn't able to really get used to it. Again, cyan accents with the little light bits in there. And then the final one is just the combat, regular combat elite. A cool weapon in game and well done again by Mega Bloks here. And this guy's looks like he's got a little bit of white detailing in there for indication of his lights. He actually has eyes painted in there. It's almost impossible to see. He has red eyes, but they're dark red, so you can barely see them, but it's still, it's there. It's the thought that counts, right? Let's take a look at these guys from some alternate angles. You can see the shared torsos between all of them and shared arms between a couple of them. A lot of shared parts here, but you know, they work together as a team well. I think they look together. Look good together. Humans, two ODSTs, and then talk about going into the vaults, a Flame Marine. We haven't made one of those in quite some time. The ODSTs, both of them very similar color schemes overall, but got the nice crisp light silver used here, whereas over here you've got a nice copper with a wash over it, so they actually kind of dulled that down. It almost looks like they only applied the wash to the copper bits. He's also got it on his helmet on the top up there, but it doesn't look like the entire figure is washed over. Beautiful, really well done. This is a real star as far as its finish and color scheme. I really like that. Here we've got just a regular light silver assault rifle. Here we've got a silver Spartan laser, and both of these guys have backpacks on. And I believe that's a paint mistake right there, but it kind of looks cool actually, the way it worked out. And then the Flame Marine, okay, he's in the old green color. You're kind of slightly muddy green, slightly olivish green. Easy to confuse for folks who aren't familiar with him with an EVA Spartan from a distance, just because of the large face shield. These are a little bit difficult to pose with the weapon, with the flamethrower, because this hose piece tends to be very inflexible. It would be nicer if it was more rubbery. It's kind of plasticky the way that it's built, and there's only a couple spots where you can really place that. But nice to have that back. I wouldn't mind seeing more of those added to more sets in the future again, because it is a pretty cool figure. I mean, he's got great presence, and you know, anytime you get a big, heavy-looking weapon, that's always an awesome thing. And then Spartans, the ultimate heroes of the Halo universe. They gave us so many that I had to zoom out a little bit and back it off. I appreciate that. So left to right, you've got your green Spartan in EVA armor. You've got a Spartan in recon armor, actual recon armor. I'm always calling everything recon. For some reason, it's just stuck on my brain. But that's an actual recon armored Spartan. Then you have a Scout who's in pretty cool black and gunmetal gray color scheme. EOD black with gunmetal gray accents. Please, EOD fans, make some noise in the comment section. Represent. Everybody who's watched my videos knows that I'm a big fan of EOD, so this is big for me. It's huge. And then you've got a Spartan in security armor with the big bug-eyed face shield or visor. And then we have two CQB Spartans, one in a bright, super bright, greenish-yellow, transparent, active camo color. Again, they went for the kind of eye sort of detail with the visor actually being visible here. So taking a closer look at these guys to make sure that I'm not being discriminatory, just because there's more of them, I'm not gonna prevent you from seeing all of their details. Again, hearkening back to older times. First off, on the left, EVA, dual wielding. Yes, dual wielding, old school. Hello, got two light silver magnums there. And then the recon dude here has a assault rifle, but it's the old style assault rifle. They've done it in a light silver here, but you can see it's not the new mold, it's the old mold. So that's cool to see that coming back also. And then both of these guys have washes that are very well done over them. Makes them, you know, look more realistic, gets the shadows in there and accentuates stuff, just looks really good. The Scout, unfortunately, is not holding a weapon here because he's supposed to be holding a submachine gun. Submachine gun, right? It's in silver. But unfortunately, I don't know if you can see the handle. It was actually kind of stepped on or squashed between a couple of dies or something. Coming out of the mold, that is unusable. Won't fit in the hand, so... another Mega Bloks fail with another malformed part. Grr. EOD, I'm not going to talk about them too much because that would be just kind of overdoing it. But you can see that you've got the, again, silver magnum. And he's got a frag grenade, which is in a dark, almost grayish olive green color. Pretty realistic color. Security armor, he's got the battle rifle in the light silver. And well done on this one. Also, on the top here, you can see the little dot is done in silver. A little bit of extra detail. He's got a frag grenade, same color. And your CQB pair here, both with grenade launchers. And this one's here is finished the same way as the EVA and recon guys were, with the wash and the green color. Well done. Looks nice. That grenade launcher looks really good in this color. It stands out, especially when you see it against a little bit of a dark background right there. Has some areas that are large and smooth that just let light through and kind of refract it a little bit. Looks pretty cool. And now, finally, I'll turn these guys around and let you just see all of them. The Scout, probably the least detailed from the back, least interesting looking overall. There's your EOD, holla, holla. And security and CQBs, right on, there you go. It's quite a wide range of different dudes. Brought back some interesting colors, some interesting molds, some interesting pieces that haven't been used in a while, interesting characters that haven't been available in the series in a long time. And it's good, it's just all good. The best thing about it though is not even what you see here. The best thing about it is what I mentioned early on in the video, $50. $50 for 20 figures, including two active camo figures, including a Flame Marine, which has lots of extra stuff and the heavy weapon and stuff. That's $2.50 per figure. Plus you get the stand as part of that with the emblems and everything. It's a fantastic deal. Anybody who is into these figures wants this. I mean, you've got to want it because it's just a great way to get a lot of figures, and a lot of them are good. And no matter what you're looking to build up in terms of your troops or what you're most interested in, they've probably got something that's of interest to you in here, because again, so many different things. So I think this is a great set. It's one of the best deals they've come out with this entire year, that's for sure. And it's just great. It's just all good all around. The only negative thing was, again, another failed part, malformed part. As I always say, it happens to me far too frequently. You can easily get those replaced. You go onto the website, use the forum, blah blah blah. Simple. They send it right out to you, not a problem. But I shouldn't be getting a malformed or missing part with every other set, so that's still a big disappointment. Otherwise, I'm still pretty darn satisfied, more than satisfied, especially for the price. So that's it for my look at this set. Hope you enjoyed that. I certainly enjoyed it. I'm going to be setting up these figures on my own collection. Might use these base plate parts pieces to actually kind of give me some good ideas for better displaying my own figures. So it's all good. And if you want to see more reviews that I've done in the past, you can just browse through those through the Mega Bloks related topic playlist on my channel or at JANGBRiCKS.com. So topic for that. You can search either place and you can stay on top of all new updates of new stuff that I put out, because I'm putting out new videos on a very regular basis. So stay tuned. You can follow my updates on the blog and by subscribing. I'm going to go build some more stuff. So I'll talk to you again soon.